Belfast, Ireland, 1911, 1 year before the Titanic is set to set sail. Construction is underway.
Hey, anonymous Mocha, come here and work below and make this ship unsinkable.
Okay, that sounds like a good idea.
Workers will be working on the up top hulls. Oh, and make the bottom ones airtight.
Aye, aye, boss. Dude, that Thomas Andrews is so cool.
Mr. Thomas, we have your camera.
Hey, come here!
Hello? Hello? Is anybody here? I'm trapped. This is all airtight, too. Help! Help! I'm trapped. I'm sealed in this airtight hole. I am definitely going to die. And I will sink this unsinkable ship. My name is Mr. Hubris, and I will bring forth your nemesis, and my soul will be free! Ha 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 ha! Ha 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 ha!
I'm Captain E.J. Smith. First of all, I would like to welcome you to RMS Titanic. I don't think there's been such a fine crew on such a fine ship. On this meeting, let's all tell each other about ourselves. Frederick, you first. By the way, your job is simple. You have to look out for icebergs and tell me which way to turn to avoid it.
Yes, sir. By the way, can I have a pair of binoculars?
No, sorry. Unfortunately, they cost $5 and we only have 7,850,462.95.
Okay then. Anyways, hey guys, my name is Frederick Fleet. I was born on October 15th, 1887. I was raised mostly in orphanages my whole life. The first time I worked on a ship was when I was 12 years old, so I'm kind of excited for this job.
Okay, next, Charles Dugan. By the way, your job is to be a chef and cook. Simple, right?
Yes, sir. Hello, my name is Charles John Dugan. I'm the chef aboard the RMS Titanic. I was born in England and I first went to sea when I was 11 years old. And I was also the chef aboard the Olympic, the Titanic sister ship.
Next, Tinkle Wild. By the way, congrats on your promotion to chief officer.
Oh, thanks, bud.
Anyways, your job is to keep first class and third class separate. Got it?
Got it. Or should I say, aye, aye, Captain. Hey, guys, I'm Henry Tinkle Wild. I am the chief officer of the Titanic. I am from West Derby, UK.
Officer James, you have the same job as Chief Wild. Keep the classes separate. Got it?
Yes, sir. Hello, everyone. I am James Paul Moody. I was born in Scarborough, England on August 21st, 1887.
Don't forget, Mr. James, I'm your boss.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Thomas Andrews, your job is as managing director, okay?
Yeah. Hello, my name is Thomas Andrews and I'm from Belfast, Ireland. I'm going to be the managing director for the RMS Titanic. I have a wife, Helen Barber, and a daughter, Elizabeth. By the way, I have built this ship.
By the way, Mr. Charles Dugan, make sure there's a lot of caviar for Mr. Andrew. I hear he has quite a craving for it.
I'll make sure to keep a lot.
I love caviar!
Well, thank you everyone for coming to this meeting.
Of course, sir.
Of course, sir.
April 10, 1912. It is the Titanic's first day at sail, and Andy Bowen has boarded the Titanic. Andy met Leslie in their third-class bunk.
Hi, I'm Andy Bowen from Chicago, and I'm a professional boxer. I like knocking out my friends and being paid to do this. If I win enough fights in New York, I will get famous and many people will bet on me. So why are you going to America?
Hey, no way, I'm a boxer too. I'm Leslie. I'm going to New York to make a living. I'm a black sister, Tony Pandy Rondo Wales. I'm 28 years old and I would love to have a boxing match with you sometime.
Friends?
Friends!
Hey, do you want to meet the other people in third class?
Okay.
The boxers go to the next third class room and they meet the Goldsmith family.
Hey, I'm Leslie and this is Andy. We are both boxers.
Hey guys, we're the Goldsmiths. This is my wife, Emily, and this is my son, Frankie.
Hey.
Hi guys.
Hey, do you want to explore this hot ship?
Sure, let's go.
There was a girl named Elizabeth. Her father was in a meeting, so she was running to her cabin. Then unexpectedly, she runs into a man. The man's name was John Jacob Astor IV.
Oh, that looked like a knockout. That was cool. Oh, I'm sorry. Please, let me help you up.
Boxing fan?
Yeah.
Where are your parents, young lady?
Oh, my father's in a meeting, but please let me buy you something to eat at the first-class diner.
I'm the richest man on the boat. Do you think I'm going to second class? Ha!
Well, okay then.
When they got to the steam room.
Wow, Leslie, doesn't this look like a good place for a boxing ring?
Yeah!
Hey, Frank! How was your life in England?
We, Emily and I, had two kids in England, and they died from a disease.
That's why we want to go to Detroit to start fresh. I also have 9 brothers and sisters in Detroit, and that's another reason we want to go.
Hey guys, you want to go to the top deck?
Sure!
And they got to the top deck.
Wow, this is a nice day for third class.
Yeah.
I am hungry.
Me too.
Let's go to the restaurant.
Don't you guys know you're supposed to bring your own food?
What? Boy, we got nothing.
Don't worry, I can give you some food.
Frank, a word please.
Yes, Emily?
What are you thinking? We can't feed them.
Don't worry, honey, I have an idea.
Hey, you guys, you're third class passengers. You can't be up here. This is first class deck.
Okay, we'll go. Let's go, guys.
Okay.
Sorry.
Hey, night in my dreams, I see you. I feel you. That's how I know you'll go.
So, Elizabeth, who's your father?
Thomas Andrews.
Wait, you mean the builder of this unthinkable ship?
The builder of the ship? Where?
He's not here, but he's my father.
Wow. So, you like boxing?
Like? You mean love. My dream is to get married to a boxer.
So, have you ever went to a boxing match?
Once. I told my father that I was going to the library, but I went to a match. Neil Carter versus Jack Johnson, and Jack Johnson crushed him with those jabs and uppercuts. But my father caught me, and he said, I can't believe this is, it's so irrelevant.
Neil Carter versus Jack Johnson? In London? I was there too!
Who are you?
I'm a first-class passenger. Isn't that all you need to know?
Not really, but enough about me. Tell me about you.
Far across the distance and space between us.
Well, I'm a millionaire going to America. America, so I got my child there. And I'm the richest person on the boat. I mean to brag, but I love sports. I even read racehorses.
Nice!
Tell us about you, stranger.
Hello, I am Joshua. I'm a married man with quite a sense of humor. Some people collect coins for a hobby, but I collect friends.
Excuse me, I'm not trying to ruin your conversation, but can you be a bit quieter?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Sorry, this is a restaurant and we're allowed to talk. Can you please be quiet? My ears are hurting from this disgraceful noise.
Oh, I'm sorry. It slipped.
Huh. Pardon me, but that was on purpose. I'm calling the ship's officers.
Hey, let's not start a fight. Remember, she's a girl.
You guys are just acting like first-class spoiled brats.
Me? Ha ha ha! Ha ha ha! Ha 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 ha! Oh, you...
Well, I must be getting back to my father. He must be looking for me.
Yeah, I guess I should be getting to bed, too.
Yeah.
Boxers disguise themselves and go to first class.
Hey you, snack group again. I already told you to get out and stay out of here.
If I were third class, well, I'd be wearing this fake, I mean mustache.
May I please have your names?
I'm Jacob, and this is John,
and this is Frank.
Wait here 1 second.
Wild and Moody turned around and started talking.
Those mustaches look pretty cool. They must be first class.
I agree, boss. Should we let them pass?
They can pass. You may pass.
Thomas, come in.
Hi, miss. I want to make a caviar song, please.
Why?
Because I am famous and I love caviar, so I want to make a song for my love caviar. I was thinking,
hello from the earth.
lyrics are going to be about around 2015. How about
near, far, wherever you are, I need caviar and something about fish balls.
Here, try this.
Wow, it's so good.
Like it?
Yup.
Best job ever. Day one, no iceberg. Day two, ooh, a whale, but no iceberg. Oh no, I ran out of steak. Charles, I ran out of steak.
Frederick.
Well, are you gonna get me my steak?
Fine, 1 second. Here, Freddy.
Thanks, Charles. Yum, steak. Ooh, a bird. Dang it, my steak.
Elizabeth was walking on the Titanic and a piece of steak fell on her head.
What the? Oh no, it's raining cow. No!
Elizabeth starts running and goes to the captain.
Captain, captain!
Hold your horses! What's going on?
It's raining meat! Send the ship back home! It's a bad omen!
We are not stopping the ship! Oh wait, what? Did you say it was raining meat?
Yes, and you need...
Boys, grab yourself an umbrella and a fork and a bucket. Let's go get some meat.
Yes, sir. I'm going to bring a bucket just in case.
Good idea.
Don't you guys see? The ship will sink.
Don't worry. Remember, the ship is unsinkable.
Fine. When you guys die, remember, I warned you.
Hey, you're not allowed to do that! Why are you doing that? Guys, get this intruder messing up the carpet!
Please, please, don't call the guards. I'm sorry. I was just getting fabric for my new dress.
Fabric?
Yes, fabric. I'm making a dress.
Add a carpet. Okay, that's really gonna itch. Anyways, I like your dress. Who made it?
Well, and it's the way I do it. I think I'm wearing myself.
No! I mean the dress! Is everyone confused or something?
Oh, I made it myself. Do you like it?
Can you make me one? I'm a spoiled pamper singer who always needs dresses.
Sure, you know I'm... actually looking for a job. Could I be your one-of-a-kind designer?
Did someone call me?
Never mind. Anyways, yes, you start right now. Give me a non-fat mocha latte with homemade whipped cream and caramel and chocolate around the cup, some cookies inside, and a cherry on top. Oh, and a side of caviar.
Oh.
And buy a little something for yourself.
Just for information now, I said I'm a designer, not a maid.
Oh, sorry. How may I pay you?
Let me think. Money, food, fabric, fame, and a brush.
Done.
Father!
That is a girl from last night, Elizabeth.
Why is she running? Wait up!
Elizabeth comes running towards the boxers like a crazy maniac.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean that.
Elizabeth, you're so clumsy.
John picks up one flyer.
You guys are boxers and you guys will have a boxing match in 2 days on the Titanic?
Yeah, you guys wanna come?
Who's training you?
We are men and we can train ourselves.
I breed racehorses and it will be perfect to train you.
I could train the guy in the red shirt.
Okay, I will train the blonde guy.
From a long distance, Layla sees three men in raggedy suits wearing fake mustaches.
Hey, officers, get these three third class guns out of here.
Boxers get caught by Moody and Frank gets away.
Gotcha.
But I was the one that caught the two boxers.
Remember, I'm your boss. And what does that mean?
You get all the glory.
Boxers get escorted back to third class, and they will lock all third class.
Hey, Moody, bring me the 100-pound door.
Why?
Because I'm your boss, and that means you need to bring me the door.
I'll bring it. Just please don't yell at me.
Moody brings Wild his door.
This door is useless.
Wild replaces the wooden door with an iron door.
Late afternoon on the RMS Titanic, Mr. Thomas Andrews was leaving the front deck to go to his room when he sees flyers saying, Leslie and Andy's epic match.
Oh no, I should take all these down before Elizabeth knows.
Hi, Dad. What are you doing?
Nothing, sweetie. I'm just hugging the wall.
Okay, then. Did you hear about third class's boxing match?
No, but you're not going.
Why not? My dream is to go to a boxing match in third class. Please.
Sorry, sweetheart, but no.
Why can't you just be like the father that I love?
Because you're my daughter and you need to be fancy like me and your mother.
Ugh, you're so mean. I just want to... Ugh!
Why is that steak on your head?
Because it fell on my head and I think it's a bad omen and the ship is going to sink. Ah!
I have a great idea. I have to go tell her this.
Thomas, wait up!
Yes, ma'am?
Get your fancy pants on. We need to go sing at the boxing match. Before you go and do all your stuff, here's a ticket for you and your daughter.
Thanks, Miss Layla. I got to go tell her this news. Sweetie, I have great news. Me and Layla are going to the boxing match in 2 days. She is the reason why we are going, because she will be singing with me and caviar in the caviar song.
What? Is that Layla?
What? Is that Elizabeth?
What are you doing here?
Ladies, calm down.
Are you serious? I can't stand Layla.
Layla is my songwriter. She's the reason why we are going to this. She will be singing the caviar song because me and her made this song. It is very important.
Don't worry, Thomas. Your daughter is just acting a little bit weird today. We're like BFFs.
No, we're not.
She's just joking around.
Okay, ladies. We have to practice for the boxing match in 2 days. We only got started.
Fine.
Let's go practice, Layla. Come on.
John wakes up and is super excited to see his best rich friend.
It's such a nice day. I just can't wait to see my bestie.
John goes to the first class hallway and meets Josh.
Hey, Joshua.
Hey, John, would you like to throw a live fish in the pool?
Why would you do that?
Just to see what happens.
That sounds random. Let's do it.
John and Josh go to the pool.
Hey, you there, what are you doing here?
We are putting fish in the pool. Wanna join us?
No, I'm already in the pool. That would be gross.
Are you sure?
Actually, I'm totally fine with fish in the pool. Toss that bad boy in.
Do I smell surging from the Caspian Sea? Is it Pringles?
Well, yes it is. I always carry a few with me just in case I run out of caviar.
Great idea! Let's turn this whole pool into a caviar farm! Woohoo!
I can't believe I escaped from the officers, but I hope nothing bad happens to the boxers. Frank sees the sign that says men allowed on boat 18.
Whoa, boat 18. My lucky number.
Frank gets off of his lifeboat and meets Elizabeth, John, and Josh.
Frank, what are you doing here?
I was trying to get away from the officers, but I don't know what happened to Leslie and Andy.
Well, come on. What are you waiting for? Let's go save them.
Elizabeth, Josh, John, and Frank go to third class.
Help me open this door.
I think this door is jammed.
Hey, there's a wooden door here yesterday.
Wild and Moody hear the noise in third class and rush to find where the commotion is coming from.
Hey, what are you first class passengers doing here in third class?
I'm the builder of the ship's daughter. I could do whatever I want.
Diggity, damn it, boss. I think that's Elizabeth, Thomas Andrew's daughter. I suggest you let her pass.
No, Moody. I'm your boss, and what does that mean?
You come up with all the great ideas.
That's right. Good boy. And no, we can't let them pass. Remember, Captain said to keep the classes separate. You guys need to leave.
Or do we?
Yes. I take my job way too seriously.
Guys, let's get out of here. Elizabeth goes running to Thomas Andrews.
Dad! The officers are not letting me and my friends in third class, and we need to get the boxers out so we can have a boxing match.
So what?
So, if we don't get them out, there will be no boxing match. And if there's no boxing match, there will be no caviar song.
What? No caviar song?
Carpet and curtains. This dress is not going to make itself, so you better help.
But it's too hard.
Oh well, you don't get to have a new dress for tomorrow's match.
No, I need a new dress for my new song.
Then get your bottom over here and give me the scissors.
Fine, but you get half pay.
No, I'm here for a new beginning. I will not tolerate half pay. Understand?
I understand, but how long is this going to take? I still have to do my makeup.
If you want to get to your makeup, then let's get started making this dress.
Fine, let's go.
Thomas and Elizabeth go to third class to talk to the officers.
Wild! Moody! Whose idea was it to lock the third class boxers in the third class?
I'm sorry, Mr. Andrews. It was Moody's idea. I told him not to do it, but he just wouldn't listen.
But, boss, it was me who told you not to do it. It was your...
Hush! Moody, don't complain in front of the great Thomas Andrews.
This job is going to be the death of me.
Well, what are you waiting for? Get them out!
Wild tosses Moody
On the third class hallway, Frank was running towards the boxers.
Hey guys, I just had a great idea for you. We just need to have a weigh-in.
What is a weigh-in?
I thought a weigh-in is when you measure your weight and think of a way to promote the boxing match.
Yes, Leslie, that is exactly what a weigh-in is.
Awesome! Let's do it!
Okay, guys, this is the instructions. You just need to pretend that you hate each other, and then we can get more money.
How do you get more money?
We just need to sell more tickets, then we get more money.
Duh. Okay, nice idea. Should we throw a few punches?
Yes, good idea, Leslie, but you just need to throw one or two times.
Okay, you better watch out, pretty boy.
Ha, 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 ha. Yeah, sure, why not?
Hey, I wonder what's going on down there. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the RMS Titanic. My name is Mr. Thomas Andrews, and I will be talking about the boxing match. Tomorrow evening, we will have the finest caviar and the finest music with the finest pink mustaches. And come on down, John Jacob Asha the Fourth!
I have an announcement to make. My new best friend Joshua and I will be betting $1 million on the match. Also, we will be selling pink mustaches.
Okay, so over here we have Andy Bowman, 210 pounds. And Leslie William, 220 pounds.
Hey, everyone, how can Andy win the boxing match if Andy's trainer, Elizabeth, is so clumsy? Gonna pay for this, pretty boy.
That's messed up. Just because I'm clumsy doesn't mean I'm not a good trainer. You take that, Leslie.
Elizabeth punches Leslie in the ribs as hard as you can.
You also take this, pretty boy.
Andy starts to punch Leslie's eye a few times.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Save the fight for tomorrow, boys.
Whoa, those boxers must really hate each other.
Yeah, oh look, those pink mustaches for sale. They look so fancy.
Yeah, let's go buy some right now.
Oh my god, I'm so excited for that because I love singing too.
After the weigh-in.
Hey, Andy. I heard that you're becoming good friends with Elizabeth.
Yes, we have.
Well, I'm inviting you to dinner with me and Elizabeth.
Oh, thank you so much. I have to go tell Leslie.
You're welcome.
Wait, Andy, don't invite Leslie. He hurt my feelings, and he called me clumsy. But it was just an act.
Whatever. By the way, my father, Thomas Andrews, needs to talk to you. Only you.
Fine, Elizabeth. I will not invite Leslie. Andy goes to see Leslie. Leslie, I just got an invite to the dinner from Thomas Andrews.
Oh, cool. Can I come too?
After you call Elizabeth clumsy, you made Elizabeth cry?
But that was just an act.
She took it the wrong way. She needs more space from you. I am so sorry, but Thomas Andrew didn't invite you. You understand?
Yeah, well, I guess I understand. Then see you later, bud.
Okay, see you later. I gotta wear my tuxedo for the dinner, by the way.
Yeah, who cares?
Hi, Joe. I am here for more caviar.
Well, about that, it seems that we might have a problem on our hands. If you keep eating caviar like this, we're going to run out by the end of the night.
Nonsense! Besides, there are unlimited amounts of caviar we spent the lifeboat money on.
Hi, Captain. We have a problem. We're running out of caviar. Mr. Andrews is eating it all.
If we really need caviar that bad, then why don't you just go fish for it?
But, sir, it only comes from the Black Sea.
Black Sea, Blue Sea, Rainbow Sea, whatever sea. Just fish for it. Besides, you have a really easy job. All you have to be is the chef, and you have to cook for the whole entire ship. Simple, right? Now give me some caviar and leave!
At the first class diner, Elizabeth and Andy sat down to talk with Thomas.
Andy, do you like caviar?
Well, I never tried it before.
Really, you need to try it. Charles!
Hi, Thomas. Let me guess. Caviar?
You know me too well.
Here's your caviar.
Here, try this, Andy.
Yum, very salty. Tastes like my grandma's fish.
She must have been the best cook ever.
Yeah.
So, Andy, you should come with me and Elizabeth to New York. You will be a lawyer and I'll make you so rich. Boxing is irrelevant.
Are you crazy? How can you say that to me? I love boxing. I will not be a lawyer. I want to box and beat up people for money.
This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, Auntie. Please take this chance to come with me and Elizabeth. You want to come?
Yes, but I love boxing. I would love to be with Elizabeth. Pardon me, Thomas, but Elizabeth, why do you have a stick on your head?
Because, Andy, the ship is going to sink. Long story short, the stake fell on my head, and I think it's a bad omen. Turn the ship around already.
Hoo 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 hoo. Nonsense. I made this ship unsinkable.
Leave me alone. Ha ha.
Caviar. I want caviar.
Me too. Excuse me, Chef. I'll be right with you.
Oh, hello.
Shush, Moody. Oh, hello, Captain. Would you like to join us?
Sure, why not?
Hello, what would you like today?
Well, one caviar for me, and one caviar... No, steak. Moody wants steak.
But,
oh, wait. Captain, what would you like?
But I wanted... whatever...
I want turkey!
But sir, that's not on the menu.
I said I want turkey, and that is an order, Charles Dugan. And anyways, you have a really easy job. All you have to do is cook for the whole entire ship. Simple, right? And bring some for Moody as well.
Hey, but
okay, right away. Here's your breakfast.
Hey, Wild, since you're the second in charge, I want you to drive the ship while I go to the boxing match.
Awesome! I mean, aye, Captain.
Oh, and Mr. Moody, I almost forgot. When I return the ship back to England, I'm going to retire and I'm going to go fishing. Would you like to come with me? We will make barbecues. I even have a beach house there. It'll be a blast!
Yeah, of course.
Hey, but I'm good at fishing too. I have a great fishing rod.
Wow, that was a great breakfast. Thanks for inviting me.
We should do this more often.
Yes, indeed.
I will see you later to make our plans. Well, I should get going.
Okay.
Bye. Tie my shoes.
But I don't want to.
Remember, I'm your boss. What does that mean?
I need to tie your shoes.
That's right. Goodbye, Moody.
In Andy's locker room.
All right, Andy. If you win the boxing match, I will marry you tonight.
This is awesome. All I have to do is knock the daylights out of Leslie, and I will marry the girl with the stick on her head.
Frank comes in. Hey, you two little lovebirds only have 10 minutes to get in the ring.
In Leslie's locker room.
All right, remember, cover and protect your eyes. You will need them. Also, use the polar punch on the last round. Got it?
Got it, but how do you use a polar punch again?
When Andy does a jab on you, you duck and hit him hard in the ribs with your right hand. Then uppercut him to set up the knockout. Then finish him with the right cross on his neck.
You have 10 minutes to get in the ring. Oh, and by the way, your best bud looks pretty vicious. Wish you luck in the ring.
Oh, that's bad. Once in a match, he actually knocked out a guy's tooth in the first round.
Remember, polar punch. Just remember the polar punch, and you will be fine.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to the epic concert. Today we will be having Layla Gaga!
I see you, I eat you. That is how I know I'll eat more. Sturgeons in the sea smell taste salty to me. You have come to shore and you'll go on and go on. Near, far, I need caviar. I believe that the stomach needs caviar to go on. Once more, I eat some more, and you're here in my mouth, so good, and the aftertaste goes on and on. I spread you on a cracker many times, and a new one will appear, and I will never let it go till I'm gone. The Caspian Sea has my salty delicacy. $270 pearl spoon can make my caviar taste good.
Near, far, I need caviar. I believe that the stomach needs caviar. Once more, I eat some more, and it tastes so good. Go on and on. Go on.
Here, this is like not fair, that I won't have my fresh caviar. We'll stay forever this way. You are safe here, my boy.
Dead meat.
Jeez, okay.
All right, boys, I want a nice clean fight. No hitting under the waist. You know the rules. Red, corners, please.
Okay, let's start round 7. Boxers, go to the middle. Ready, set, box! Okay, they're circling each other again. Oh,
this first punch from Leslie. He punches Andy straight in his face, now in the ribs. Oh, now Andy's punching Leslie. But he's keep punching Leslie. Andy's keep punching him in his face, in the ribs, in his left eye. Oh, this is bloody. But Leslie's keep locking. Andy punches Leslie in the ribs, over and over and over and again. Leslie will not quit blocking, and Andy will not stop punching. And now here goes Leslie, down.
Round 7. So far, Andy has already won round 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, bing! Oh, Leslie saved by the bell.
Okay, boxers, get to the corner. And let round 15 begin. Ready, set, box. Oh, this first punch from Andy. He punches Leslie. Oh, Leslie's punching Andy. Oh, Andy's punching. Keep punching Leslie. He's punching him. He's doing anything he can. Leslie's also punching him. Oh. Andy's keep punching him in his face. Eye, ribs, in the ribs. Oh. Andy will not quit, can't stop, he won't stop, he'll never stop, I'm pretty sure he will never stop. Oh, Leslie's punching him back, Andy's punching him back. It's his chance for Andy to finish him off, but Andy gets
throws a weak punch, but Leslie throws a hard punch. He punches him. Oh, Andy's almost down. Oh, I don't know this move, but Leslie just did this awesome move. Oh, Leslie is punching him over and over and again. Oh, Andy's down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It ended. Leslie William is the winner, the champion of the Titanic.
Making my way down to have a victory. Yeah, I love money. Woohoo!
I won, you lost. For once in a lifetime.
After the boxing match, Andy was knocked out after the polar punch.
Wake up, Andy, wake up. I love you so much. I'll marry you anyways. Let's get married right now.
Wait, what? My best buddy's getting married to Thomas Andrews' daughter? I'll be your best man. Let me go get the ring.
Leslie finds a rock and a string and makes it into a ring.
Here, take this.
Will you marry me?
Yes, Andy. It's beautiful.
Come on, take this ring, Leslie. Here.
Will you marry me now?
Oh, Andy, I love it so very much. It has the ruby colors I love.
Oh, this is beautiful. This will be the best night of our lives. But before that, where's the priest?
I was a priest for at least 2 years. I'll do it.
Thank you so much, Charles. But before that, Leslie, Andy, I will have a gym in New York for you, and you guys will box all day and night.
Yes!
Oh, yeah.
The groom and bride stand on the stage.
Andy, do you take Elizabeth to be your wife?
Yeah.
Elizabeth, do you take Andy to be your husband?
Of course.
You are officially husband and wife. You may hug your bride.
Come on, Andy. Let's go groove the night.
Celebration time. Come on. Yeah. Celebration time. Come on. Everybody dance now. This party.
Hey, Moody. Give me some coffee and make sure it's hot. Not like last time you gave it to me freezing cold.
Moody goes to the coffee machine.
Moody, get me the door. Moody, get me some coffee. Moody, tie my shoes. Oh, Wild always tells me what to do. I don't even get what Captain put Wild as my boss. Here's your coffee, boss.
Oh, look, a dancing whale.
Wait.
That's an iceberg!
Moody accidentally spills the coffee on Wild.
Ah, it burns! Get me some ice!
Here, boss, I got you some ice.
April 15th, 1912, there two hours later after the ship sank, Elizabeth, Goldsmith, and Leda sitting in fear.
See, I told you guys. I wore this stick on my head for 3 days telling everybody the ship would sink. And who listened? Nobody. My dad died, my husband died, and we were only married for 2 hours. He was practically unconscious.
Oh no, all those women and children I could have saved. Oh no, my jewelry's gone, my dress. Everything I ever wanted is gone. Fiddlesticks, even my golden mic. No!
For a second, Layla, you sounded nice. Just for a second.
Fiddlesticks! The $2 million I made at the boxing match is gone.
2 million? You made 2 million. You could have bought me a diamond ring.
Charles was in the water.
Charles, is that you?
Little help here? Y'all want some liquor? I survived this way. It actually worked. This raises your body temperature and it helps you survive the ice water, but help me first. Frederick, why are you alive? You should have gone down with the ship. After all, you are a gentleman, aren't you?
But they assigned me to row the lifeboat.
Freddy, you coward. You could have saved a child's life. After all, you were a lookout, and your job was to, I don't know, look out. I can't believe you survived.
Oh, but it was a dancing whale, and it was so beautiful. I've never seen it. Why did it have to be an iceberg? I believe I will live to regret not dying.
Andy was all I ever wanted, but now he's dead. Okay, I'll be honest. I had a crush on your dad.
Yeah, you and the whole boat.
Yay, the Carpathia! Look, let's get on!
Okay, but first, I need to do something special.
Andy, you were all I ever wanted. Now I want to do something. Take this.